Well, deck the halls with words and numbers. 'Tis the season to play countdown. Next, here on 4.
To dream the impossible dream.
Problems recording your favourite TV show? Let the video co-pilot take over. The easy way to record your favourite shows. No confusing menus or complicated manuals. Just pick the channel you want to record, and with the co-pilot, it's as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, pick the day. 2, set the start time. 3, set the stop time. That's it. Records the exact time and day you choose. Anybody can do it. Never miss a show again. Available at Comet and other leading electrical retailers.
Do you dream in chocolate? Then discover Lindor, crafted with passion by Lindt's master chocolatiers. When you break its shell, Lindor's lusciously smooth center starts to melt, and so will you. Lindor from Lindt.
Always wait for him to make the first move. Hugo Deep Red. Your fragrance. Your rules.
4-in-1 is the first dishwasher tab from Finish to combine a powerful detergent, salt, rinse aid, and glass protector action all in one tab. This gives you the 10 power actions essential for truly brilliant results, time after time. Finish 4-in-1. One tab, 10 power actions.
To dream the impossible dream.
You have to box clever to clinch the deal or no deal at 4:15. That's after a Christmas that counts, here on 4.
Countdown weeks begins, ladies and gentlemen, and at the end of it, it is, of course, Christmas Day, and we're in the Christmas spirit, aren't we? It's exciting,
isn't
it? We
are. This lot have shared a bottle of sherry and 89 straws.
I thought they were making a noise.
Yeah, I know.
I thought they were making a noise. Do you get excited by Christmas the way you did when you were a kid?
I love
Christmas.
Do you?
Yeah.
I will have every bauble in the world. You know those houses that you see in the paper where they've got Santas on the
roof? One near me with all the lights all over it, yeah.
I want a house like that.
Well, it's for sale, this one.
Is it?
Now. I've got a joke. Somebody sent a joke in from a lady called Samantha Barcroft. She'll get one of Des's little doodads. Yeah, for sending it in. It's great to have Countdown back, she says, and I thought I'd send you my favourite joke. During World War II, an Irishman, a Welshman, a Scotsman and an Englishman were captured by the SS. I'm going into character now, Carol.
Oh, go on.
Because the SS commanding officer said, "You may all have one last fish before you're shot." Okay. One last fish before you're shot.
One last fish.
The Irishman said, "I'd like to see 100 Irishmen doing an Irish jig."
Yeah.
And the Welshman said, "Well, I'd like to hear 100 Welsh choristers sing Cum Ronda." And the Scotsman said, "I'd like to hear 100 Scottish pipers play Scotland the Brave." And the Englishman said, "I wonder would you be kind enough to shoot me first?" How about the accents?
Very good.
I thought I was going to get them the wrong way around, but I managed to squeak through.
That's
Samantha Barcroft of Crew in Cheshire, you get our special Countdown book. It'll be signed to you, of course. Now, we have Marie Hayden, our very good champion here from Dublin. She's won 4 in a row, but the scores have gone down a little bit as you've gone on, but you've had tough competition. Marie is an engineer for the Electricity National Control Centre in Ireland, got a big job over there. A golfer, because we're member of the same golf course
That's
in Ireland. We've mentioned it before, La Hinch, famous golf course. Mm-hmm. And you're going very well on the show and you're enjoying yourself.
Having a ball, it's great.
Obviously.
Great fun.
And the challenger today is Mr. Paul Johnson from Southampton. And a special day on two counts. A, you're on Countdown, and B, it's your birthday.
It is.
Well done. Many congratulations and many happy returns to you. Paul's got a daughter a daughter, Bethany, who's, I think, about 10, did you tell me?
She'll be
watching the programme. Yep. So good afternoon, Bethany. How are you? I hope Dad gets on well for you. Paul is a tanker driver for a petroleum company. You drive one of those great big beasts, do you? It's got, about 8 wheels on it or something?
12, actually.
Just the 12?
Yeah,
12 wheels.
That's all.
How do you reverse one of those, then, round the corner?
Don't know. It takes a lot of practice.
With great care. Yeah. With great care. And you like the odd game of golf and visiting the gym. And as you told me yesterday, you're a Liverpool supporter.
I am.
And they're going great.
Well, they are.
Good luck to you. A big round of applause for our champion and a challenger, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, in Dictionary Corner with Susie is Clare Balding, my old colleague from the BBC, racing specialist, but an all-round good sports journalist and broadcaster. Now, listen, the philosophy of the horse, I never understand. Mm-hmm. Does the horse in a race know that the intention is to finish first? I think they just get beaten and driven and get there.
I don't think they know where the finishing line is, and I think that's what the jockey's there for. But they're naturally, they're herd animals, and in the herd, you know, like any sort of animal, you'll get natural leaders, you'll get ones that like to be in the middle, and you'll get the lazy ones that want to just be at the back and do nothing. And you do get racehorses that actually don't want to be in front. You've seen them, you've probably backed a few of them. They get there, they look like they're going really well, and they will not put their heads in front of another horse. Yeah. And it's extraordinary, it doesn't matter what the jockey's doing on top, it's very hard to make a horse do something it doesn't want to do.
Do you know what I think? I think they go, we'll all run down there for a bit of sport, then we'll go and have a bag of hay.
Yeah, I think they do. They say, these stupid people, they want us to run round and round in circles for no apparent reason.
And all those mugs are betting on us.
You know, it's easy, let's go do it, they say.
Anyway, good to see you again, Clare. Right, let's start the show. And Marie, as the champ, as always, we'll start with your letters, please.
Good afternoon, Carol.
Hiya.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Marie.
J.
And another.
M.
And another.
And Y.
And a vowel.
I.
And another.
A.
And another.
O.
And consonant.
R.
And another.
P.
And a final consonant,
and
please.
A consonant, thank you. And S.
Starting the clock. Birthday boy, how'd you get on, sir?
Five.
Just five. Marie?
Six.
Six. What's your five, Paul?
Proms.
Proms? And Marie?
Mayors.
Mayors. Yep. Mayors. Mayors is fine. And proms okay?
Proms fine,
proms
too,
okay.
Yes.
It doesn't score, though, because mayors does.
Yeah.
Six for Marie. Good start by a champ. Clare?
The other one in there is majors.
Mm. Majors and mayors, yeah. Mm. Nothing much better
really
than that.
Really hard, that one, no, I think.
No. No, it's quite a tough
Sorry.
One, that.
Yeah.
Tough start for them. Right, six for Marie. And Paul, we'll now have your letter, sir.
Hello, Carol.
Hi, Paul.
Start with a consonant, please.
C.
And again.
R.
And again, please.
T.
Vowel.
E.
And again.
A.
And again.
I.
Consonant.
P.
Consonant.
D.
And another consonant.
And L.
Time starts now. See what Marie got?
Just seven.
Seven, Paul?
Eight.
Eight. Right, Marie?
Platted.
Platted. Now, an eight.
Particle.
Particle.
Well done. Yeah, that's really good. That's really
good. Particle. Very good eight. Right, Clare, Susie.
Yeah, there is one other eight.
Yeah.
Which is dipteral.
Mm-hmm. Dipteral.
Yeah, architectural term. It means having a double peristyle or row of columns.
A double what?
row of columns, really, called a peristyle.
Peristyle.
I'm not pretending I knew what it meant.
No. 8 points for Paul gives you that slightly, just the 2 points. It's early days, of course. Marie, let's have your letters.
Consonant, please.
M.
And another.
D.
And another.
G.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another.
I.
And another.
A.
And a consonant, please.
T.
And another.
R.
And a final consonant, please.
And Z.
Time starts now. Now then, Paul.
Risky seven.
A risk?
No, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
A risky six.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, Marie.
Risky seven.
Risky seven. Let's do. Let's have risk everywhere and do a six first.
Imaged.
Imaged. Right. And seven.
Triaged.
Yeah, I think that's both fine. Triage. It's just. Is there as a verb to decide the order of treatment of patients or casualties in the hospital, and image is also a verb.
Okay.
And,
well, I used to ask young Connery, who was here the other week, whether he knew the meaning of the word, and he rarely did. Did you know the meaning of the word?
So I'm a big fan of Eeyore, so...
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, right, okay, well done. Well done. 13 plays 8 at the moment. And, Paul, we will now move on to your letters.
Consonant, please.
T.
And another.
N.
And another.
S.
Vowel.
E.
And another?
I.
Consonant?
R.
Consonant?
T.
Vowel?
A.
And a final consonant?
And P.
The timepiece begins. Right, Marie.
Eight.
Paul.
Eight.
What's your eight, Paul?
Painters.
Painters and.
Painters as well.
Painters. We had that the other day, didn't we?
Yes,
painters.
We did.
Yeah.
We
keep
did.
Getting painters.
Yeah.
Get some decorating done. This is the place to come. 8 points apiece. Now, dictionary corner. What have we got? Anything better than painters or?
We've got nothing better in terms of numbers. I ought to just say they migrated for the letters before, because people at home will be saying, there was an eight-letter word in there, it was a migrator, because you two spotted it late, didn't you?
Yeah.
But in this one, there is also patience.
Yep, carrying on from triage from the last one. And transept is there as well, transept, T-R-A-N-S-E-P-T, which is in a cross-shaped church. It's the two parts which form the arms of the cross.
The transept.
The transept,
transept, yeah. Okay. 8 points apiece for the guys here. Now it's numbers time. Marie.
One large and five small, please, Carol.
Thank you, Marie. One large and five small. Thank you. Three and two. Two and seven. Four and 50. And a target for you and Paul of 757.
757. Paul, any good?
Yeah, 575, but I haven't written it down.
No, you don't mean 575, do you?
Yeah, 757, sorry.
Right, okay, you haven't written it down. And Marie?
Yeah, I have 757 and it's basically written down.
Basically written down. Let's have the non-written down one then.
3 plus 4 is
7.
7, times 2 is 14.
Yeah.
Times of 50.
Yeah.
Is 750.
No, it's 700.
Oh, there you go then.
Yeah.
Bad luck. Bad luck. Marie.
50 plus 4 is 54.
Okay. 50 plus 4, obviously 54.
7 times 2 is 14.
Yeah.
If you multiply the two together, I think you get 756.
You do indeed.
And then 3 minus the other two is 1.
You haven't used
added
that.
Added on.
Excellent. 757.
Very good, very good, very good. Bad luck, Paul, because you thought you were in with a good shout there.
I did. Yeah. Never mind.
Very good, Marie. That's good, wasn't it, Carol?
Yes, it's good.
That wasn't too easy, that one.
No, there was another way of doing it, but, I mean, yeah. That was lovely. That
right, was good. Well, so the scores... Yes, well done indeed. The scores at the moment, 31 and 16. Plenty of time to go, of course. And now it's time for Miss Clare Balding. Clare.
Well, it's been so much fun being here, and in the run-up to Christmas, it's quite nice to get out of having to wrap up presents and all of that, which I'm rather behind on.
Work with Willie Carson.
Or with Willie Carson in, actually wrapped up in a box, ready to jump out, because that would be the ideal Christmas present, particularly for me.
Dress him up.
exactly. But some children, I don't know whether you've noticed this, some children get terribly confused about the concept of Christmas. And a lot of my friends have got quite young children, and one of their little three-year-olds brought home a drawing the other day, and her mother looked at it and said, oh, that's a beautiful drawing of Father Christmas, but he looks in a little bit of pain. And the child had drawn, having slightly got her wires crossed, had drawn Father Christmas on the cross. Something's going wrong there, isn't it? I think the message of Christmas was slightly lost. But life can be a bit confusing when you're young, and my brother was totally obsessed with racing, and when he was at school, the teacher asked the children in the class, can you name the seasons of the year? And my brother thought, actually, this is a question I can answer, so up shot his hand, and he said, National Hunt and Flat, which are the only two seasons of the year that matter to him now, and he's a racehorse trainer, and that's what he does for a living. But it also, when you're later in life, sport can be very confusing. And, I mean, as Des knows,